first and foremost, there's been very good progress, very encouraging progress in the reduction in poverty as defined by the official poverty line in the last 10 years. The first compelling message around that is that it's time for us to raise the bar and to take a more comprehensive look at poverty. The second compelling message is that as you look backwards and as you look forward, almost two-thirds to three-quarters of the poverty reduction in the history in the last 10 years, as well as you look forward in the next 10 years, is going to come from job creation, particularly non-farm job creation and farm productivity improvement. That was a surprise to us, how large is the contribution of this element. The third dimension that's of importance is that if you look at the social side, much of the impact from the social spending can be elevated quite significantly. Much of the impact from social spending can be eliminated, can be raised very significantly by making sure that more of the money that's spent reaches and is impactful for people, whether it's on NREGA or it's on healthcare or it's on education. To make spend more effective, it has a very significant impact. As far as social spending itself is concerned, it needs to go up. But we believe it needs to be directed much more, particularly in the direction of healthcare and creation of certain kinds of social infrastructure in areas where the social infrastructure is missing. Public expenditure can be made more effective in many ways. We've studied 200-300 examples of public programs and social programs. Number one, they can be made more effective by creating more transparency around them. Use of IT, for example, that leads to more transparency. And if you look at the PDS system in Tamil Nadu, they use IT to say when the trucks are leaving a certain spot, and that then leads to more effectiveness of public spending. The second way of making public spending more effective is to involve communities. So in the case of Chhattisgarh, in the PDS system, the panchayat's involvement has meant that the spend is more effective. And finally, by involving private contractors as well as social organizations or NGOs for delivery, is yet another way where the government then holds them accountable.
Right.
It's yet another way of making public spend more effective. So outcome-based measurement, we're a big votary of it. In this work, we look at many, many different programs across the world, of social spend, of infrastructure building, etc. The most successful programs have this one thing in common, outcome-based measurement. Was the impact defined that was expected from the spend or the infrastructure creation? Did it happen? Was it measured? These are all critical aspects. So outcomes and measuring outcomes is a very, very important dimension of making this effective.